You might imagine, quite a few students from our area attend Virginia Tech, including Jared Jenkins. He joins us now live. Drove home to campus from campus to Mount Airy. You were sitting this morning on the campus of Virginia Tech about 7 o'clock, eating breakfast with a friend, sitting in a car. Tell me what you saw.
Yes, sir. That occurred early before the first shooting, and we were sitting probably, I would say, a good 15 to 20 yards outside of West AJ, and was talking, going about our normal day, just having fun, getting ready to go to class here about a little after 8. And I heard multiple gunshots, just loud. It sounded like a handgun, but they've not confirmed that at all yet, really.
And you say multiple. How many are you hearing at this point in time?
I would say at least three shots were fired. And then at that point, it was total chaos. Girls were coming out screaming and crying. I had friends that lived in West AJ, and I'd been getting crying myself, which I've been all day concerned. And I just had received news on my way home that one of those victims was one of my friends. So I've been having to deal with that all day. And it's just been a rough start. I mean, as you can imagine.
Sure. Well, clearly, when you hear gunshots, you know something is wrong. How long was it before you realized the magnitude of the tragedy that was unfolding on campus?
Oh, it was probably just a couple seconds. When I heard the gunshots, like, at first I thought maybe the gunshots was coming my way because they're loud. I didn't really know where the shots had come from. And my first thought was to get to safety. And there's a place called Dietrich Hall that is a little food hall right below West AJ, and I led probably 15 to 20 people into Dietrich this morning and stood in there, and I really wasn't sure that it was a shooting going on at this time. I thought perhaps maybe somebody had called in maybe like a bomb threat or something like that, because it's just how the people were running out, and just it looked like something you would see in a horror movie.
Mm-hmm. Like, and how soon before police started responding, you started hearing sirens and ambulances respond?
They responded not as fast as I would have expected them to at that time, but as soon as they came in forces. The Virginia Tech police was there. The Blacksburg police was there. I believe they even had some help from Christiansburg. And it was just, it's something that I'll never forget for the rest of my life.
And without mentioning any names, you said you do know at least one person
at least
killed.
One.
How is this affecting you and other students there on campus that something like this would happen at the school that you love so much?
Well, personally, I mean, I'd love Virginia Tech. I'm a Hokie through and through, and I'll be there at the football games getting rowdy with the biggest of them. But right now, I would say my school spirit has just drifted down to about like this. It's just, you don't know what to do next, because, I mean, a part of me is afraid to return to school mm-hmm. after that. But I'm sure that our local authorities and stuff will do their best to ensure the safety of our students and stuff. So.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's certainly understandable. Classes, of course, canceled tomorrow. Don't know when they'll resume, but when you go back, or if you go back, what do you think it's going to be like for you?
It's definitely going to be a different Virginia Tech. I expect to return to Blacksburg to a silent campus, pretty much kind of stunned. I mean, I may go to Cook Counseling myself mm-hmm. and get counseling myself. It's something like this is not going to go out of your head within the first week or month or so. It's going to take probably years to cope with, and because whether or not I knew of none, I may have not known of the other 30 victims, but I mean, it still hurts me as a student, because I mean, that's just like losing a classmate right. and a fellow Hokie. We consider ourselves brothers and sisters.
Right.
And I'm sure that the alumni out here watching this and all this stuff, and they feel the sympathy just as much as I do. And my thoughts and prayers go out with any family members that's out there now, and including the ones that I do know.
All right, very well said. Thank you for joining us today, Jared Jenkins, on a very difficult day. We certainly appreciate that, and thanks for coming in from Mount Airy today.